Hello and welcome, my name is Nilaus and this is episode 21 of our Let's Play campaign of Factorio, where we are playing mainly vanilla with only some quality of life mods, but no gameplay mods, at least at this point, maybe some for the endgame. What we need to do this time around is actually start working on the mega base, but that's going to be a huge amount of work, and it's going to be really strange because I am honestly a bit afraid of starting it, for that simple reason that I'm just afraid of doing something wrong. But it can't be all wrong when that's a big forest I have to cut my way through here. And I forgot the car. As always. Oops. So I just want to make sure that I can walk through this path, and I brought a few of these along so you get a nice walking path from my base to where I want to start the mega base. So the mega base will be fueled by trains coming in, and I have this idea that I'll build on one angle, and where's the car? Come on. And once I'm done with that, or if I need more, then I can sort of like make it into a square or something like that. I'm kind of inspired by what Scarhoff has built. I really like that setup. I think it's beautiful, and that's kind of what I want. But I want to make something. See, what is tempting when building these mega bases that will be primarily driven by beacons and then robots. Then you build to like an area, and you build for the one thing and then an area for another thing. Why am I building it like this? It's stupid. But that doesn't connect very well. So you end up having sort of like, okay, so I have the copper one place and that needs to go into the green circuit. That's fine. The keys need to go into the red circuit. That's fine. To go into the blue circuit. That's also fine. And then suddenly you have that being very far away from something you need. So I'm kind of, okay. Do not have anything related to that. So let's see. I'm gonna have, this is just building it in mini format. So I'm gonna have two main entrances here. I don't know, it's not for scale. But that will be sort of one for coal. No, one for iron, one for copper. And they actually have to be really close together. These are more like blocks of themes of something, not so much actual designs. But what I think we'll have is, yeah, these are just representing furnaces. I can't build the furnace because I don't have enough steel, as always. So I'm kind of imagining some kind of area where I get my different components in. These are sort of my city block areas, and they progress towards the middle one. Basically, we'll have like iron coming in, copper coming in, maybe oil coming in, and then we have to build the whole facility here, where in the beginning, I mean, these will be smelters and like basic components. So this would be plastic, and that one could be something like batteries, because those are basic components. Then I need, yeah, they can't do that, but this is going to be copper. Then for example here I'm going to do green, red, blue, because I don't need that much blue. See, already here we can see the fuck up of having it like this. Green, red, blue. The green has to be next to the blue for sure, because there's these like a hell of a lot. And then for example here we can make something like isn't there a way that I can see all of it? That would require a requested chest, but I don't have that. I don't have a steel chest, and I can't build a steel chest apparently. But it would have to be something like this. I'm not going to put signs in here. I can keep that in the old base. I'm also kind of needing a build everything. So it's going to be something like this. I can't really imagine at this point what I need, but these will be sort of the components for the rockets. We have fuel, will definitely be built over here. We have the control units, I believe. Those require blue circuits and stuff. And what's the last item? That's the steel. So we'll definitely... Okay, so in this case, I would have like copper, iron, steel, right? That makes sense. And then over here, we'll have the lightweight components because they're very steel heavy. So let's keep something like this as in memory. And we're going to have some kind of way in for... So copper, iron, steel. The problem is iron is not in the middle. Don't like that at all. And this could be copper, iron, steel, something. Yeah, that's probably okay. I don't know what else I need. Let's have a look at the robots, the end game here. Satellite's not really. Processing units, rocket part, yeah, that low density structure. That's all fine and dandy. What was it I looked at? It was that one. Right, okay, so this one might be something like solar and accumulators up here, because they're also going to be needed in vast amounts to fuel this base. And I think something like this. The great thing about it is what we can do then is I can just flip it, because that central square is going to be where I spawn from the rockets. I can just flip it up here so that I'll get like... That's the whole point. If I need to scale things up, I can do that. Right, so we can have things coming in from all angles. This is when things get like mega big. And I think that's going to be the idea. I might just take a third train in here with coal and stone, I suppose. I'm going to need some of both, for sure. All right, so I'm going to leave this here because that's my blueprint, so to speak. But just so that I get an idea of, and also you get an idea of what I want to achieve here. Then we can always come back and see if this turns out to be anything like the reality that I'm going to go into. But now we can sort of see that these are all city squares according to my city square concept. Then that kind of makes sense. And then we'll have solar power outside. And these will be our entrances to the base. Now I kind of like what I'm seeing. So this is going to be long term, very, very long term, if we even get that far. There. Good. That's up and running. Now, how the hell do we get started? I think what we need to get started on is actually building some... and this is where the problem starts. I need to build a lot of railroad tracks. What's going to be the first thing I build is actually the train station, so I can do my smelting here. So I'm going to have to build some seed box up here with smelting. And in order to do that, I need railroad tracks. I'm going to build something here for railroad tracks. Unfortunately, railroad tracks is synonymous with iron, and iron, or not iron. Let's see. Yeah, steel plate. Steel plate is not my best friend. I wonder actually how I can improve the steel at this point. I don't think I can. This one is really constrained by what I have down here. But what I can do is just... Actually, no, just as long as I have it. Yeah, what I can see is these are all working. The problem is that these are not being filled up, and as long as they're not being filled up, this is not going to work. Wow. Does that mean that these are actually full? Interesting how uneven this is drawing. And let's get, oops, there. Not that it really matters, but it's still a better way of doing it. Okay, so I also need stone. How the hell do I get stone in this context? Stone comes from here. All the way over there. And that's when I need some. I don't like building it at this point, but I kind of feel like I have to, because I want to leech off what I can at this point. So you're going to build railroad tracks. Which obviously also means that up here I'm going to steal something. Oh, this is filthy. I don't like it. I feel so dirty for doing this kind of thing here. It's not good. And grab it and leave it. And put things into a box. What a big box that is. I hate the fact that the steel is so constrained. There. What else? I need stone. Okay, I can get stone from here. I can just branch it out. It's really not a big deal. I feel so ashamed and about this base. It's about the most ugly thing I've built since my season 2. But I'm just like, yeah, I don't care. I just want to move on. I just want to build something. Good. So we now have leeching some more here. Not good, because that's actually my main constraint. So I'm gonna need some trains and train tracks. That's my train tracks, that's taken care of. And the next part is actually some trains, not really a big deal. What I do need is actually a combination of more solar power and actually, okay. What I also need is to get over and see if I have accumulated enough blue circuits, because I only need blue, oops, that's a bad idea. Oh, it actually didn't do anything. Oh, I drove through it, but didn't break it. That's actually kind of strange. All right, so let's see. How many do we have? Not 100. Fucking hell. Ugh. Still, the problem is green circuits, but at least they're not that big of an issue anymore. I can also see all of this nice iron I have. Okay. Great. That should keep this one going for a while. But not a lot. It's actually like a ridiculous amount. Okay. Let's see. Power armor. What if I want some power armor? That's 40. That's actually pretty close. And then a bit of steel. That should be manageable. That's 38. Just gonna need a few more. Come on, give me two more. Where do we have some steel? I have some steel down here. I can grab that and... All right. Good. I have a lot of steel actually. And one, only one. Come on, one more. unfortunately, the next problem is going to be, 100 more. That's ridiculous. Can I build these solar powers? Ugh, that's disgusting. And I also need that. I guess I have to leave this running for a while. But at least at this point, I can build a power plant, a power armor. And that is something. That's something, right? How many do I have? Oh, that's kind of a lot. What else? Alien artifacts. Do not have enough of those. That's actually a bit of an issue. What I'll then grab is... Okay. Alien artifacts here down here. And that's definitely not enough. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. One power armor coming right up. Next challenge is how the hell do I equip any? I could build those, no problem. Yay, power armor. Junk. Put it in that junk file. That one. So that's actually cleaned out a bit of the inventory here. What about here? That's great. Now I have a power armor, though I don't have anything to put in the power armor because it's so damn slow. I am suspecting that what I have up here is still not enough. No, it isn't. Whoop. So I'm gonna grab everything again. Might as well grab these as well. There. I will also need some roboports. All of them? Yeah, let's take all of them. It's gonna be a pain though. Oh, this is interesting. You are just filling up. I don't actually mind this, do I? I don't think so. No, it's just gonna fill up. Definitely don't mind. And the plastic is needed in this one? Yes. Right. Let's figure out what's the next move in order to start establishing the mega base. And that is, where's my car? That's there. I need to get some guns, some ammo. Oh, that's disgusting. I don't want to grab this one, having that take all my steel because of that. Ugh. Good, power is okay, so I don't need to worry too much about the power. Oops, get in the car, please. Some power points, I suppose. I have 50 plus 41, so 91 power points. That should be okay. Let's go out and have a little conversation with the aliens out here. I don't see many aliens, but I see a few up here, and I think I'll just go say hi to them. That's a huge forest. What the fuck? That's gonna take forever to get rid of. How the hell are we gonna get rid of that? That's so big. Oh, aliens? Aliens? Yeah, aliens. They're not that. They're not that dangerous at this point, are they? Nope, they're not. So I'm just gathering all of these little teeny tiny things here. I know that you're there. I know there's something there. There. Good. And moving on. Over here. I'll go up here and just see if there are any aliens. Yes, there are some aliens. Actually, technically, I'm the alien. That's already also something somewhat up here. Oh, that's a bigger one. Yeah, goodbye. I think I need more repair thingies. This is my least favorite way of killing aliens. But at this point, I don't really feel I have a lot of other options. and I kind of have to wait until I get my power armor and my roboports, because once I have the roboports, then I can start cleaning things out very easily and also build in a much easier way. This is both for getting some space, but it's also a matter of, did I just forget where my, I left my car? Yes, I did. Oh, there you are. Great. Thank you. Please come along. Right, so at this point, I feel that I have pretty much control of how I want the mega base to work, but how do I build a mega base in based on the little things I have here? Because it basically the first thing I have to build is something to build it bigger. And that doesn't, oops, that doesn't seem like a great idea to me. That the, where the hell are the aliens? I know they're right here. Are they here? Yeah, they are. They were. I'd offer someone to say this is cheating, but it'll be fixed. Let's call it fixed in a future episode or in a future version of Factorio. They don't want to do just that, and I totally understand them. It's just aliens are stupid. There we go. Said it. That's it. This one, I mean, that's 225. That sounds like a lot, or it doesn't, but it's 2,250. Science packs, and that's all I needed for. I needed for science packs and some power armor and stuff. But that's about it. I don't think I need a lot of these. Maybe if I go for some like SpaceX, I don't know about iron cannons, that kind of thing. And again, this is just incredibly simple way of doing it, of cleaning out aliens. But I'm not here for having fun and games with the aliens. Then I would have definitely turned them up, but I'm just here for getting some space and some of these purple dots. And that seems reasonable enough for me to commit genocide against this alien race. Raya, you're down here. I think this is going to be enough of space for me to get started. Again, easy peasy. And now we're actually, oops, that was exactly what I didn't want to do, is take up the ones that are broken. Don't pick them up, leave them be until they are fixed, and then we can pick it up. Excellent. Here, okay. That is enough space for me to get started. Okay, I can just see something down here at the border of the periphery of my vision. Hello and goodbye. I also get this because their evolution factor is not that much. Well, it's still evolution factor 42, that's not very much, but they seem very docile, these aliens. I have also set them as that, but and this is nice. This is a new oil deposit. It's definitely gonna come in handy. And let's see. Okay, let's have a look at our space we've just cleared and see if that makes sense. Yeah, it does make sense. I mean, I'm gonna start it from this corner here and just work our way up. And it's very nice to have this oil deposit down here. That's gonna be really handy. Fortunately, I have to go all the way up here. This is also very nice, and those will be capped pretty soon. Alright, okay, here we have our road back to civilization. Well, actually, I can consider the road. I'll definitely do that. I just use these as I can. actually I don't want to go through this minefield because I'm going to use it, and that would just be stupid for me to do that. But I can bring it over there anyway. That should be fine. And now we'll just go back. I like this concept of a base. Let's see if I can figure out how to build it. But that's definitely going to be in the next one. This took a bit more time to do than I had thought. Let's see, how many do we have here? 23. Is it working? No, it's not working. It's not working because of lack of sulfuric acid. I cannot accept that. That doesn't make sense to me. Why are you not making enough sulfuric acid to get all the way down here? Oh, that sucks. That sucks. I don't want it to be the constraint here. Is it because this one is not doing anything? Yeah. These are all working as fast as they can, trying to empty this. It is being emptied. That's great. This one is empty as well. I don't like this fact. And I'm gonna fix it. And I'm gonna fix it right now. Not that one. X1. It's gonna be fast fix. And it's just one, but I'm in such short supply that I must get them. Here, we're gonna go back and do blue circuits, and they're gonna come from here. Fresh from the source, you're gonna be the first one to build, so definitely. And we'll have input and output. All right, I'm gonna accept input, output. Here, one of these, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever. Great, so I only have 23. That's kind of far away from the 100 I need. But anyway, that's enough. We're gonna continue next time. Then we have more tracks to start building, laying out some tracks, and we also should have some more roboports such that we can actually build the framework for the roboports. I do have some ideas about how I want to build the roboports, because it'll be slightly different on a mega base than what I usually do. I won't be using any of these anymore, so I could actually just take these and cut them way down, because I'm not going to use much. I'm going to use these. A lot of these. What did I want to grab? Maybe some steel chest, though. That is hurtful. There. That should be enough to get us going at this point. Okay. Thank you very much for joining, and I'll see you in the next episode. Cheers. Bye.